In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to control the frequency and phase of sketch lines in Flair for Maya, either globally or per material. I'm Henriette from Artineering and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's get started. In the previous Flair for Maya tutorial, we learned how to control and art direct the amount of sketchiness within sketch lines in Flair for Maya. But we didn't get into how to control the actual appearance thereof, which can be done either globally or per material. We should always aim to set the global defaults first before going into detailed art direction. So let's show the global attributes by clicking on the globe icon in the Flair shelf. Directly underneath Sketchiness Max, you will find Sketchiness Frequency and Sketchiness Phase. These two attributes control the appearance of the sketchy lines. Before we get started though, let's remove the toon line by setting the line intensity to 0. That way, we can concentrate only on the sketch lines. Setting a low sketchiness frequency will generate larger sketch waves. Setting a higher frequency will make the sketch wavier to the point of making fizzy lines. Depending on the look that you're after, you will probably remain within lower frequencies. However, fizzy lines do have their unique uses. For example, remove the sketch coloration and set the sketch density to 1. We now have a fizzy edge that blends with the object, similar to the warp style in Flair. You can also push the sketch coloration to 1.0 and reduce the sketchiness to just have a bit of offset on the sketch lines. Now you have textured tune lines that stick with the animation. If you would like to see more ways to combine effects to form new ones, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with a bell icon to be notified about future tutorials like this. Back to sketching things up. Underneath Sketchiness Frequency is Sketchiness Phase. On fizzy sketch lines, we won't see the behavior of the attribute well enough. So let's set both the sketchiness and frequency to about 5. Now when we move the Sketchiness Phase, you can see how the sketch line offsets move around. This is useful to generate different sketch lines at the same frequency. The attribute can go to any value beyond the slider, for example 100. That way, you can keyframe it to have boiling sketch lines at specific frames. The sketchiness frequency and sketchiness phase can also be controlled per material. For this purpose, select an object with the Flair material and click on the matte icon on the shelf. This will open up the attribute editor with all material attributes, including the feature noise offsets. If you remember from the sketch tutorial series overview, sketch lines are generated from the feature noise attributes that we enabled. Enabling it also allows us to offset the noise frequency and noise phase attributes for the material, allowing you to have custom sketch frequencies and sketch phases per object. This wraps up the sketchiness controls over sketch lines. We learned how to change the frequency and phase of the lines to control the sketch and even generate entirely different looks. We also learned how these attributes can be offset per object within the materials. In the next tutorial, we will learn all about coloring lines, toon and sketch lines alike. We have touched upon some sketch color attributes for the fizzy line examples, but there is a lot more to have full control over sketch line colors. If you've already seen the toon line color tutorials, the attributes work the same way, so feel free to skip ahead or watch the video again for a refresher. Thank you for watching this far. If you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our Patreon to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in this beautiful list of credits. Color you on the next one.